Hello, and welcome to this tutorial on getting started with Kafka and Java Spring Boot. In this tutorial, we'll be using IntelliJ IDEA as our IDE, Maven for dependency management, and Java as our programming language. First, let's start by creating a new project in IntelliJ IDEA. Select File, then New, then Project. Choose Maven as the project type and make sure to select the Create from Archetype checkbox. From the list of archetypes, choose org.apache.maven.archetypes, Maven Archetype Quick Start. The Spring Boot Starter dependency is added to the project to provide the necessary libraries and dependencies for building a Spring Boot application. This starter dependency includes a number of other dependencies, such as Spring Boot, Spring Boot Auto-Configure, and Spring Boot Starter Logging, which provide the core functionality of Spring Boot. Once you've added these dependencies to your pom.xml file, IntelliJ IDEA will automatically download and install them for you. This means that you don't have to manually download and install the dependencies, as IntelliJ IDEA will take care of this for you. In addition to the Spring Boot Starter dependency, we'll also need to add the Spring Kafka dependency to enable integration with Kafka. Now that we have our dependencies set up, let's create a simple Kafka producer and consumer using Spring Boot. First, create a new class called Kafka Producer and annotate it with @service. In this class, we'll create a method called send that takes in a message as a parameter and sends it to a Kafka topic. @service, this annotation indicates that the Kafka Producer class is a Spring service. This means that Spring will automatically create an instance of this class and make it available for auto-wiring into other components. @autowired, this annotation is used to auto-wire the Kafka template instance into the Kafka Producer class. The Kafka template is a Spring-provided class that simplifies sending messages to a Kafka topic. Private Kafka template string, string Kafka template, this line declares a private field of type Kafka template string, string. The two type parameters indicate that the key and value of the messages being sent are both of type string. Public void send, string message, this method defines the public API of the Kafka producer class. It takes in a string message as a parameter and sends it to a Kafka topic. Kafka template.send my topic message. This line uses the auto-wired Kafka template instance to send the message to the Kafka topic named my topic. The first parameter of the send method specifies the name of the topic, and the second parameter specifies the message to send. Next, let's create a Kafka consumer by creating a new class called Kafka Consumer and annotating it with @service. In this class, we'll create a method called listen that listens for messages on our Kafka topic. Now let's create a command line runner to send messages using our Kafka Producer class. Create a new class called myCommandLineRunner and annotate it with @component. In this class, we'll auto-wire the Kafka Producer class and call its send method in the run method of our command line runner. Before we can run the application, we need to create a main class to start the Spring Boot application. Create a new class called application and annotate it with @SpringBootApplication. In this class, add a main method that calls the run method on the Spring application class, passing in the application class and the command line arguments.
Before running our application, we need to configure our application to connect to a Kafka server. To do this, open your application's configuration file, example application.properties or application.yml, and add the following properties. Spring.kafka.bootstrap servers equals localhost 9092. Spring.kafka.consumer.groupid equals mygroupid. Once the application is running, you should see a message in the console indicating that the message "Hello, Kafka" has been sent to the Kafka topic using our Kafka Producer class. In this tutorial, we've learned how to set up a simple Kafka producer and consumer using Spring Boot. We've used IntelliJ IDEA as our IDE and Maven for dependency management. We've also seen how to configure our application to connect to a Kafka server and how to set the necessary properties for using group management with our Kafka consumer. Finally, we've seen how to run the application to verify that messages are being sent and received correctly. Thank you for watching this tutorial on getting started with Kafka and Java Spring Boot. I hope you found it helpful.